Today, we stroll on the alleys of the park where a few trees, contemporary to the morning star of poetry, lead us and make us dream. In his last years of life, Eminescu himself wandered on the large alleys, traced among the clusters of trees of different species. The park still preserves the artificial lake, where once people could row boats, while the army brass band was playing in the central kiosk on holidays. The great critic George Călinescu described the Central Park like that. When I think of Botoșani, I remember an enormous pagoda in a forest with monstrous trees. The forest was so dense that walking through it made me fall sick with exhaustion. The pagoda was a pavilion on a promontory, while the surroundings nothing else but a summer theatre. The forest was the park, but today, seeing it again, it seemed to me that the impression was not too exaggerated after all. It gives a strong impression of a green maze. Time's fullness is mirrored by the old men in the park and the young ones singing their love. The bustle and hustle are fostered by the water rippling in the artesian well, rising and descending like arrows meant to pierce you. The natives enjoy this oasis of peace in the heart of the city every day. Winter settles over the lively park, and the landscape changes. A blanket of snow covers the cold land. Everything is white, while the flakes fly into a magnificent ball. The park shines unhindered in the ice heart of winter. The trees lowered their arms under the weight of the white. The bushes and other trees create a wonderful, mysterious lace. It is an enchanting landscape. The soft and fluffy snow carpet rules over the land, which seems dead. It is winter, so it is fairy tale time. Then let's discover the city where culture rules. Let us discover the history of these inhabitants through the easiest and most pleasant way. Set on Moldavia's platform, the city of Botoșani is the center of a region which marked its evolution through its outstanding values, both spiritually and culturally, but also on a social and economical level. The greatest cultural and scientific Romanian personalities rose from here and became well known. Though Botoșani was first documentary attested in 1439 in the Chronicle of Bistrița, there are even older testimonies, such as the inscription of the Armenian church in the center of the town, dating from 1350, demonstrating that the market town existed long before it was documentary attested. Botoșani is perhaps the most important city in the country as regards the people that were born there. You cannot say Botoșani without thinking of Mihai Eminescu, the greatest poet of the nation, of Nikolai Yorgar, historian and politician who played an important part in the country's political life, of Stefan Lukian, one of the country's best painters, or of George Enescu, who practically needs no presentation. The most important building in Botrushany is obviously the premises of the mayor of the city, which is closely connected to the name of Mihai Eminescu, constituting a real attraction for visitors. Built at the end of the 18th century, the construction bears the imprint of an eclectic style of German influence. As Stefan Cevatiuk mentions in his monograph of Botrushany, the first budget of Euphoria adopted in 1832 mentioned in the expenditures chapter the sum of 400 lei as rent for the municipality house. Halting in the town hall of Botrushany, we admire the imposing beauty of the edifice. The meetings of the local council are held in probably the most beautiful room, where the councillors, besides making important decisions for the town, cannot help but admire the room. The ceiling of the meeting room was restored, preserving the model and all the original ornaments. The unique three-floored chandeliers ennobled the meeting room, being made of stained glass manually in Dorohoi. The theatre could not be absent from the cultural landscape of Botrushany, where it has a long history. 1860 is a turning point in the history of the town theatre. The theatre was built in town according to models in the West, situating it among the first places in the country that could take pride in a cultural establishment endowed with a stage, two rows of boxes, a pit, a dress circle and other annexes. It was known as Petrarchy Christa Theatre. Still, the history of the local theatre does not start in 1860, but much earlier, on November the 27th, 1838, when the Caragiale Nicolini Theatre Group, called then the National Theatre of Botrushany, performed the play Wellington's Uniform, a one-act comedy by Otto von Kurzbier, and the two-act pantomime Trua Dupe. Other plays were performed in December 1838 and at the beginning of 1839. The 3 months of genesis of the local theatre had a great importance. They represented the only performances in Romanian in the theatre season of 1838-1839, Botrushany being the first town in Romania that used the national language on the stage. Chances are that the theatre of Botrushany regains its old luster. The local administration is close to signing a contract for accessing European funds in order to modernize the building. A building that attracts the visitors' eyes is the Ventura House, the present-day headquarters of the Popular Art and Crafts School. Built in 1850 by the boyar Aleco Ventura, The house was the place where the elite of the Botoşan society gathered. Due to a European project amounting to 3 million euros, carried out by the Botoşani County Council, the building was completely renovated and is of an amazing beauty. When you say Botoşani, it is impossible not to think of George Enescu. Born near Dorohoi, the artist left his mark over the cultural life of Botoşani. But the symphonic and choral music in Botoşani does not begin with George Enescu. It starts earlier in 1889, when the first great show was performed by the Metropolitan Church Choir of Iași, directed by Gavril Muzicescu. The concerts of the Choir of Iași were hosted by the stage of the Petrache Crista Theatre. The inhabitants of Botoşani lived a remarkable musical event on June the 28th, 1890, when the great soprano Haricleia Darclay, accompanied by the pianist of Iași Theodore Burada, sang pieces of Massenet, Thomas, and Gounod. Between 1894 and 1931, George Enescu performed 14 concerts in Botoşani. On May the 21st, 1917, he also gave a concert for the disabled soldiers. The puppet theatre for children has had a long tradition in Botoşani, starting in 1953. The cultural institution was set up on May 1, 1953, by a decision of the public administration of the city, and the first manager was Max Weber. At first it was called the Red Tie in the note of the epoch, but starting with 1973, the theatre took the name of a well-known Romanian puppet, Vasilache. The first night show took place on June the 25th, 1953, with the performance The Little Gander, directed by Florica Teodoro. The quality of the Vasilache Theatre puppeteers is given by the impressive number of performances and spectators, tours in the country and abroad, and mainly by the prizes won a long time. The cultural progress of Botoşani imposed the creation of a public library. This was carried out by Theodore Boyan, one of the most spirited and enlightened mayors that Botoşani had in the 19th century. Since 1934, we find in documents the name of Communal Library, functioning at 11 Armenian Street in a residence called Spring. Many personalities donated part of their personal libraries to this one. Grigore Antipa, the scientist, donated 2,000 volumes. Here is what the Bell newspaper wrote in an article in 1945. There is no mistake that this town holds the largest library in northern Moldavia, containing a significant number of rare and extremely valuable books. After the Hitlerite bombardment, the youth of Botoşani gathered from abandoned houses, under the ruins, in the streets, from everywhere, scattered books. Some of them present in the library patrimony today. Registering an annual average growth of 18,000 volumes, the current patrimony is made up of about 500,000 items, including books, periodicals, records, film strips, slides, maps, standards, audio-video materials, etc., while the number of active users rose to over 150,000. An impressive building makes you stop for a few moments and look at it in the center of the city, on the Uniri all-pedestrian area. It is the Vasescu House, of an eclectic architectural style, where the Department for Culture and National Patrimony of Botoşani carries out its activity. Ilie Vasescu, former prefect of Dorohoi, lived there, but after his death in 1915, the building was inherited by his brother Ilie Vasescu, who owned it until 1925 when he died. A year later, his heirs, Alexander, Viorica and Marietta, sold it for 3 million lei to the Ministry of Education, which used it as a boarding school for girls called Carmen Silva. Built around 1890, the house escaped communist demolition, which pulled down the buildings in the center. And due to the rehabilitation carried out a few years ago, the Vasescu House remains a reference construction for Botoşani. The restoration and modernization of parks and green areas, as well as of their ornamental lighting, has been a steady preoccupation of the local public administration of Botoşani. Public lighting in many areas of the city was modernized through a project financed by the European Union within the Regional Operational Programme 2007-2013 by way of the European Fund of Regional Development of 7.5 million lei. It implies all pedestrian areas, the residents of the City Hall and the exit roads to Yash and Suceava. At the same time, the project also meant restoring artesian wells and planting shrubs in the city, so a simple stroll there can have a special charm. A permanent preoccupation of the local administration is to create facilities for spending the spare time of the inhabitants of Botoşani. After finalizing the sports hall Elisabeta Lipa, a skating rink was arranged close by, which attracts thousands of children, teenagers and parents every year. The interest manifested by the people in recreation areas determined the municipality to start works on the Cornișa Regional Park for tourist and sportive recreation. The House of the Teaching Staff, a historical monument, was built by Nicolae Sofian, former mayor of Botoşani, in 1891. built before 1898, the Law Court of Botoşani owes its present-day appearance to the changes made between 1906 and 1914 by the Italian masons Gambara and Vignali in Romanian eclectic style. Prasa House, known now as the Belvedere Hotel, is one of the most valuable architectural monuments in Botoşani. Built at the end of the 19th century in an architectural style of French influence, it has a very rich exterior decoration. Prasa House is an example of recovering an old building while, for Botoşani, a huge gain. Urshan Fisher House was erected around 1890, being one of the most beautiful buildings of Botoşani. The Rapsodia Hotel, elegant and with a privileged location in the city centre, wishes to redefine the notion of tourism in Botoşani. The architecture of the commercial centre of Botoşani, or the Old Centre as it is known to the locals, is renowned on a national level because it preserves valuable architectural elements hardly ever found in other cities of the country. Until recently, it was known that the whole commercial centre was destroyed in a fire in 1887, but researcher Eugenia Greciano ruled it out. She came with the argument that many of the buildings were added floors on the ground floor that resisted or even survived the fire. The architectural details, such as the years noted in plaster or on the iron railings of the balconies dating from 1850 and 1860, bear witness that the medieval center was not completely destroyed. The traveller in the region of Botoşani has the revelation of knowing some places where faith has always been a defining note of their identity. Among the religious establishment of Botoşani, St. Nicolae Popovici Church, erected at the order of Stephen the Great in 1496, is perhaps the most beautiful church in town. Artur Gorovei says that the reason for building this church by Stephen the Great was his love for Maria of Hrlo, who gave birth to his son Petru Rareș. He couldn't find a better place than Popovici around there, and there he erected in 1496 the beautiful church that still stands today. From an architectural viewpoint, it is the most successful church synthesis at the peak of the flourishing Moldavian style, built on a cross plane with its entrance to the north and the steeple on the nave. Now, after the restoration works, which capitalized on the original painting, the church can be compared to Voronezh Monastery. At first a parish church, then a monk's monastery, and after the secularization of 1863 again a church, it has remained a permanent reference place on the map of the town. The prior Minos Psizgiant, in his travel notes published in 1830, stated that St. Mary Church was built in 1350. The same idea is shared by Prince Nicolae Stutsu in his work Statistic Notions on Moldavia in Iași, and by the priest Bedros Mamigonian, who also studied the Armenian churches in Moldavia. He goes even further, specifying that 1350 is probably nothing but a date when some repairing works took place, as a church had existed before that. Christian Chomak also states in his monograph, Botoşani in 1832, under the title The Romanians of Armenian Origin, that the first Armenian church was built in Botoşani in 1350. The church was erected in its present-day shape in the 17th century. A gospel written on parchment in 1354 in Crimea has crossed many centuries to us and is preserved in the church even today, being consulted by Nikolai Yoga himself. Searching even deeper in the history of the church, Elena Florica Schuster is convinced that an Orthodox church made of brick could not be built in Botoșani before the Romanians had already built one. Anyway, the actual Orthodox Armenian church, St. Mary in Botoșani, is not the one built in 1350, as the architecture proves. Certainly, it underwent radical changes along the centuries and consequently does not show today its primitive style. The Orthodox Armenian church was erected around 1626. The church sheltered beautiful altar curtains made by Armenian craftsmen at Tokat and Constantinople between the 12th and 18th centuries, using the technique of printing in wax patterns. An old 8-roomed house in the churchyard, demolished in 1985, sheltered a printing house and the Armenian primary school for boys, set up in 1835, and then for girls in 1866. Uspenia Church, or the Assumption of the Lady, built in 1552, is the third oldest church in town after Popovici and St. George. It was built by Lady Elena during Petru Rareș's reign. The inscription above the old door, now covered, has the following message: "With Father's wish, helped by the Son and committed by the Holy Ghost, I, the servant of my Lord Jesus Christ, Elena, Emperor Despot's daughter, desired with a good thought and inclination to build this church in the name of the Assumption of the Holy Virgin, who gave birth to our Lord and has forever been pure. It has been done in the year 1760, or 1552, on August the 15th. Being located right in the center of the town, it was considered from the very beginning a cathedral, a title officially recognized in 1903. The church shelters a real treasure of art, comprising valuable paintings, sculptures, and old books. This sanctuary became a permanent place of homage brought to the great poet Mihai Eminescu, as this was the church where he was christened. In a sweet language of the middle of the millennium, the words of the lady stand proof of the passing of the sanctuary over the centuries, being carved even today in the inscription above the entrance door. We cannot overlook two more aspects in connection with the cathedral of the city. In 1872, the first public clock was set in the belfry. And also here, special guards signaled the fires to the firemen by shooting or by tolling the bells. Located at No. 1 Nicolae Iorga Street, the Memorial House Nicolae Iorga is a building for whose preservation almost all the intellectuals of the city fought a long time. The stylish cottage built in a Moldavian architectural style delights the visitors' eyes even now. Even though exposed to degradation, the house was rebuilt from the ground, according to the model of the old one. In his autobiographical book, A Man's Life, The Way It Was, Nicolae Iorga said that the dwelling was rented from Magyuala Vizdojasa. We shut the door behind us and go away to explore the love for beauty. When, simple, rustic and lonely, placed in a sea of verdure, we come across the house of the great painter Stefan Lukian. Renewed and whitewashed, with a garden full of flowers, it is waiting for us as a hospitable hostess. The painter's bust is standing imposing in the front yard, while two clay pots found their sleep propped up on the fence. The magic of colors unleashes the moment we go in. On the easel, a painting, seemingly finished yesterday, tricks us that the painter might return to his work at any moment. In the other side of the room, as if in an exhibition, some of his works stand proudly. Lukian left a work which gives the smallest detail a significance in the absolute. He created a most particular work, but profoundly modern, linking the Romanian art to the most authentic trends of modern art. Another room of the humble house shelters the dusty piano with its worn-out keys. In another corner, hung on the wall, stays a painter. His face is only sketched but looks as if carved in flesh. The interior of the house brings back to the present the idea of traditional life, due to the furniture, household objects, and the place where food was cooked. An embroidered blouse woven on the loom is eagerly waiting to be worn at the village feast. In a corner of the room, on the wooden table, two greenish bowls are waiting to be filled with hot broth. The interior space is well balanced and warm. Welcoming the hearth stove reminds me of my childhood spent with the grandparents, as I was staying by the fireside, throwing some brushwood into it from time to time, while Grandpa was telling a fairy tale and I was listening to him through laughter and giggles. Beyond all doubt, we couldn't leave the land of culture without visiting the museum. The administrative palace of Botoşani County, which has hosted the County History Museum for 30 years, was built at the beginning of the 20th century, according to designs made by architect Petre Antonescu. Its style is eclectic of French influence. The building work was assumed by the contracting firm Vignali & Gambara of Iași. Although the foundation stone was laid on October 4, 1904, the work proper started in 1905 in March. The construction was finalized on November 28, 1906. The museum capitalizes on the most important elements of the rural civilization of Botoşani. The main occupations such as agriculture, animal breeding, hunting, fishing, and beekeeping, traditional crafts such as spinning, sewing, furrier's trade, pottery, and the popular costumes, customs and traditions specific to the region. The 17 rooms of exhibition, located at the ground floor and first floor, present the most significant moments in the evolution of Botoşani region from prehistory to the present day. The visitor is invited to discover vestiges of civilization in Paleolithic, Neolithic, Bronze and Iron Ages. The administrative palace was the first building in the county that was electrified and got a central heating. By far, this cultural hearth constitutes one of the most interesting regions of the country. And no matter how much we could say about it, there would still be something else to add.